so you feel like that you may stand it. And feel like that somebody might be praying against what you got, what God got in you. But don't listen to that jazz. You know, you keep on going, oh God. Your mind is your racing back and forth, thinking about all these things, and life has just been whipping you all day and so forth, causing you to have these headaches. That's what's wrong with your head. You know, you got your money problems and so forth. Seems like I got no money to pay too much or nothing over these days. You really taking this thing by a faith walk. But you know, but ain't nothing in your pocket but a little bit of lint. Ain't no new, but a little lint. Can help the fucking man. You don't know if you're coming or going, but you're trying to put together enough strength to get to the house of God to receive because we love the Lord. But God is saying, going over into 2010, to cast your eyes forward and not backwards. And don't have to hold on to these things and experiences that happened to us in 2009. Don't get caught up in dwelling on these things. Oh, we're into 2009. The Bible says in Isaiah 43:2, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle against you. It don't feel good when you step into something hot, but you ain't gonna take you out. If you want to hit people, the Bible says to cast your cares upon him, but he cares for you because there's rest. There's refuge in Christ. There's relief in Christ. And God is about to do something for his people. And if you're sitting up in here right now, you're not one of his people. This message ain't for you. I know I'm one of his people. And I have to check myself multiple times and show that I'm the rightful people who are careful. So, receive this blessing. The people of God have been suffering long enough in 2009. The Bible says in John 10:10, the thief cometh but to kill, steal, and destroy. And God Christ has come that you may have life and have life more abundantly. Some people might say, hey, the devil is coming across you. But let me tell you something. The devil is under God's feet. He's only allowed to do what God says he's allowed to do. And all those things that you put through it online were meant to make you, not break you out, but to make you. And it says that I've come that you may have life and life more abundantly. Now that is a choice you need to choose today. Whom you will serve. I choose life. I don't know about you, but there's too many things that have been lingering in 2009 that I don't have time for. The Bible says the kingdom of God suffers violence. And the violence takes it by force. And I'm telling you, a few weeks ago, God started me up violently. And I began to warn that spirit. And look, Satan in his eyes, let him know that he's not going to have his way. I don't know what's going on with him, but it's time to pull out your feet, Lord. Do you have any guts? Do you know any scripture? Can you pray? Can you fight the spirit? You have that fight in the street. Let me see you fight up in prayer, Father. How about that? Things above and not below. That's the problem. We let our mind go into captivity. If we keep focused on things above, we'll get those things down here below that are required for us and that are set out for us. The Bible also says to be carnal minded is death, and spirit minded is life and peace. I'm sick of death banging around on everything that I touch or everything that I'm around and so forth. I'm trying to bring out the right thing. I don't know what you want. The Bible says there's death and there's life in the power of the tongue. And see, that's so important because we've been speaking death over so many people, speaking death over our own situations that ain't no life. So that's why nothing's wrong to protection for you. We need to start taking things back that belong to us. And we need to speak death on those things which go against God and speak life on those things that God has for you. That's the problem. It's time to get. But it's time to close every doorway, every portal in your life, your family, your household, whatever it may be. Close the portals up. Shut every door. Anoint your house from top to bottom. Fill off every crack in your mind. You need to be Jesus. You need Jesus. It's time to take it. It's time to get bold. Ain't no sense of sitting there and all subtle and so forth. It requires a response from the people of God. Until you get that response, then something gonna come down for you. When they walked around the walls of Jericho, they walked around shouting and the walls came down. If you don't shout, I dare you to get to that secret place in your house and begin to roar in the spirit because Satan, his time is up here. You know what I'm saying? Everybody sitting up here needs to go ahead and take a moment and just start saying his notice that you have been arrested in the name of Jesus. We submit you under the Holy Ghost. I don't know where you're gonna go, but you're gonna get up out of this house. Took me into the scripture 2:19. And it means, behold, I Lord. One of you people tonight in your life receive it. And she knows you not know it. Yes, you know it. Now, God just told you what God said.
Hallelujah.
I live in the rain, in the wilderness, and rivers in the desert. My life in 2009, I've been walking through a desert. And you know, you walk in a desert, there's cracks all in the ground. Too much of our foundations have been cracked. Been destroying our minds and so forth. God sent forth the river, the water, the life. That's what he's about to say to you. God said that the weapon has formed, but it will not prosper. And you want to think about weapons, when you see a big old machine gun pointing at you, you might get nervous. Don't get nervous. It ain't going nowhere. It's just sitting there looking at you and you looking at it. It's your job to tell you what to do. Warn us, baby.